Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to learn how to simplify expressions with variables. And this expression is a fraction, which is another word for rational. So sometimes you'll hear them called rational expressions, which are just fractions. Okay, so here's our first example. We have 24x to the 5th, y to the 6th, divided by 15x squared, y to the 4th. The first thing we want to do is take our numerator, which is the top, and do a little factor tree. So I'm going to take 24 and I'm going to write the factors 4 times 6. I'm going to do break it down again to 2 times 2, and then 6 breaks down to 2 times 3. So I'm going to take those factors and I'm just going to rewrite 24 up here as 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. Now let's look at the variables. X to the 5th. That means I have x times x times x times x times x, that's x to the 5th, and y to the 6th is y times y times y times y times y times y, or 6y's. Those are all the factors of 24x to the 5th, y to the 6th. Now I'm going to do the same thing to the denominator. I'm going to take 15 and draw a factor tree. Well, that's just 3 times 5, so let's bring that up here, 3 times 5, and then x squared is x times x, and y to the 4th is y, 4 y's. Now I get to do the fun part. I've done all the hard work, I've written all my factors out. Now I'm going to start canceling, because any value divided by itself is 1, so the 3's will cancel. An x right there will cancel, and another x will cancel. Now, I don't have any more x's in the denominator to cancel, so I'm going to go over to the y. So the first y, the second y, the third y, the fourth y. So those are all gone. So what do I have left? Let's see. I'm going to take all the factors and multiply them back together to get my final answer. So 2 times 2 is 4, and 4 times 2 is 8. So that's 8. X to the 3rd, and then y, I have 2 y's left, so y squared, and then in my denominator, the only value that I haven't canceled out is the 5, so all that is over 5, and that is how you'd write your answer, okay? 8x cubed, y squared, all divided by 5, or you can also write it as 8 fifths, x cubed, y squared. That is a correct form of the answer also. Okay, so let's try one more. Okay, let's do our factor tree of 16. So 16 is 2 times 8. 8 is 2 times 4. And 4 is 2 times 2. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16. So 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. And b to the 5th, or a to the 5th, so a times a times a times a times a, and a b, and then a c to the 5th, c, 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 c. That is my numerator in every factor. Now let's take our denominator. We have 20, so 20 is 2 times 10, and 10 is 2 times 5, so I have 2 times 2 times 5 in the denominator. Let's write out our factors for a squared. That's a times a. B cubed is B times B times B, and C to the 5th is C, 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 C. Okay, now we've got all of our factors written out. We can now cancel out, because any number divided by itself is 1, so when I cancel that out, I've canceled out and created a 1, another 1. Okay, those are all the coefficients that I can cancel. Now let's go to the A's. I can cancel 1, 2 of those. A B, let's see, I got 1 B on top and 3 on the bottom, so I'll take off one of those, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Every single one of the C's cancels out. Okay, so let's see what we have left. Okay, the factors I have left is a 2 on top, right? Oh, I have a 4 on top, don't I? 2 times 2, whoops. I have a 4 on top, and A times A times A, or an a cubed, and then my b is gone and all my c's, so I'm finished with the numerator. Now let's go down to the denominator. I have a 5, Both of my A's canceled out, but I have two B's left, so I have a B squared. So there we go. There's my final answer. A 4A cubed, B 5B squared. And that is the final answer. Hope this video was helpful on learning how to simplify expressions that have variables.